Okay, so hi everyone. So I'll be continuing on the opportunities for Islamic wealth management and planning, whereby as my first point, I will be specifically tackle in the country of Malaysia. So my first point is Malaysia being as a hub for the Islamic wealth management. So over the past two decades, there has been plenty of efforts from the government to promote the growth and development of Islamic finance industry, and also with collaboration of the Bank Negara in Malaysia to have the vision of the next 20 to 30 years to make Malaysia as the indisputable global hub for Islamic finance. And we can see that Malaysia is number one in Islamic finance industry in terms of the awareness and the applications, and this is a good opportunity for Malaysia to attract especially those in the Middle East areas, the oil producing nations, whereby we can see that since there have been a sustained increase in price of oil, so those investors would have to invest in other areas of division, such as, well, it's a good opportunity to invest now in the Islamic finance industry. And secondly, with those of the vision of Malaysia to become the hub, so it would be expected that Malaysia would be the cosmopolitan of the Sharia reference center, and there have been various initiatives taking place, like the nationwide initiative from the Malaysia Islamic Financial Hub, and to create and innovate in search of new ideas for the financial products. And we can see that over the years, Malaysia's private wealth management industry has been developing very rapidly, and there is a need for the industry to develop and offer a more comprehensive package of wealth management service and solutions to meet the diverse client needs. So right now, there's an opportunity to cater for a bigger market in the Islamic finance industry. And since these Islamic products are relatively new, there are also opportunities for them to innovate on the existing Islamic services to be more flexible and to be more comprehensive on the packaging of the services offered. And this would definitely induce more investment from other countries. And we can see that there has been, for the Islamic industry, there has been global product acceptance and initiatives from the government to increase the cross-border linkages with other jurisdiction in view of the benefits of greater market access. So moving forward in the investment of sukuk market, so the sukuk would the attractiveness of the sukuk to ensure the tax neutrality and offering the tax deduction would definitely attract more investors to invest in it. Okay, that's my point.
Hello, my name is Irfan. As we are all aware, conventional banks offer Islamic products and services similarly to Islamic banks in order to be competitive in the industry. With the rise of awareness among Muslims regarding Sharia compliance, more and more people are investing to Islamic banking compared to conventional banking. A more conductive and effective competition provides a better product in serving consumer in Islamic wealth management. Islamic financial institution gives more development action plan for creation variation of innovative Islamic products. In terms of regulatory support for Islamic wealth management, it is usually being linked to financial institution such as Islamic banks and in Malaysia. Bank Negara Malaysia acts as a central bank. A good boundary, best practice and procedure will enable banks to assist consumer in educating and translate information in which is required in order for decision making to be made. By having a robust system for Sharia compliance, regulated jurisdiction will be enabled, hence inviting more people to invest based on Islamic wealth management. taking advantage of Islamic wealth management, which is growing and advancing. Economic profitability of a country can come into a success by applying Islamic financial principles. We believe that it is a bright future for Islamic wealth management if regulatory and system are transparent and improved. Regulatory implementation of Islamic wealth management can be based on Islamic Financial Service Board, IFSB, and AAOIFI standards, or equivalent to for other Islamic banks. Adoption of common standards, best practice, and synchronization of terms used will help to boost up and market Islamic wealth management.
Value-based intermediation, enhancement to Islamic wealth management institution. Benegas come up with a value-based intermediation framework. This is to actually enhance Islamic wealth management institution, such as Islamic bank and also type of providers, which actually offer you product and services that are due to Islamic wealth management institution. What actually we are focused on? So there's three key sustainability areas for BPI. Number one is the planet. So as a steward of the planet, so the intention is to make sure that BPI are actually able to make sure there's a sustainable in terms of this environment. Second, basically to its people, to make sure there's to make sure there's an inclusion between every single individual in the planet, so there's no wealth gap between the poor and the rich. And finally, to actually making sure that Islamic financial institutions are actually able to make profits. So in a way that you are able to actually fulfill all these two other key sustainable impact areas. And what are the internet income of the BPI is number one, to offer an innovative product and also to create a better market segment in Islamic financial institution. And second, it's to provide a better practices and in terms of Islamic banking and also takaful. And lastly, to have a collaboration with stakeholders, which is inclusive of non-financial as well. So in a way, BPI is actually focusing not only on the financial side, but also they're looking at non-financial, especially in terms of our offering, where it will actually cover not only financial, but also non-financial, such as environmental and also social. And what are the purpose of BPI is to finally to have a level playing field between Islamic financial institution and also conventional financial institution, so that they're able to actually compete and also to provide a better Islamic product and services, and eventually to actually generate better profit, so that they were able to be on the same level or might also actually increase a better level compared to non-Islamic or conventional financial institution.
Okay, Assalamualaikum. On my part, I'm going to elaborate more about the challenges, especially in the instrument of investment. What is the popular product that mostly Malaysian or for the Muslim or non-Muslim that show the interest lately is one of the product called Islamic Unit Trust Fund. And it's also becoming increasingly prominent of the late. It's been sought by all investors. As we know, the main objective for the such fund is to invest in the portfolio of halal stocks that comply with principle of Sharia. So in the return of Islamic interest, we'll also avoid the avoidance of riba and or usury through the process of cleansing the purification. Okay, in terms of the process buying and selling investment in unit trust, both conventional and Islamic is about the same. And then what is the real challenge is the market function that based on the interest and interest rate became less interest of Muslim to pursue, in which have turned out to be a great hurdle for Muslims. And in this country, to invest in such market that interest is strictly prohibited in Islam. So by the increased demand alternative to the interest based market, which is Sharia compliant, has promoted the Malaysian government to take various measures and invention in order to introduce interest-free market, which is Sharia compliant, that it can be attract more investors who are yet to invest due to Sharia compliant issue. And the Islamic investment also can be described as the investment in financial service or any other investment activities which complies with the principle as established by Sharia. This means that Islamic unit trusts are still considered fairly new in the market compared to conventional rate. The prospect of Islamic financial product, particularly in unit trust, is bright, is very bright, with further support and encouragement from the government. However, in order to become an international Islamic financial hub, several measures have to be implemented. For example, they must overcoming the consensus among bankers and Islamic jurists, encourage proactive participation in research and development, and education to the general public. First, the problem that occurs due to different views between conventional and Islamic practitioners. For example, in the case of unit trust, some companies may neglect to deduct zakat from their profit. In contrast, Islam suggests zakat to be paid to the needy and poor. In conjunction to this, Sharia Advisory Council, SAC, has to become more proactive to tackle this deficiency. This also should readdress back the matters that relate to Sharia principle and conduct proper discussion to overcome the issue in proper manner. Lately, there are some comments from the public complaining about the calculation of profit between the Islamic product, which is almost close to the conventional one. Therefore, the government should more proactive role to overcoming this, because it may bring some confusion to the public. Seminars and information through mass media is practicable to educate people about the concept of Islamic finance. As a conclusion, to become a hub of world Islamic financial hub, the government and the private sector have to give more effort in Islamic financial subsector, particularly in unit trusts. Thank you.
Hi, my name is Haryani Ashikin Binti Ahmad Sani. I will be discussing on the challenges faced by Islamic wealth management involving financial activities in banking sector. So, in general, Islamic Bank in Malaysia began with the establishment of Bank Islam Malaysia Berhad in 1983. By end 1993, there were about 31 conventional banks with Islamic windows. If you ever heard of Maybank Islamic, Hanyu Islamic, CIMB Islamic, and so on. According to Rating Agency Malaysia, Islamic finance is developing at a remarkable pace, where by end of January 2019, Islamic finance comprised of 32% of the overall loan system. Despite the fact of Islamic finance growth, we can see that the standalone Islamic bank is somehow stuck in the initial stage of product differentiation. One of the challenges faced by Islamic financial institution is the competition from the conventional counterpart. Looking at the ever-changing and dynamic environment, Islamic bank needs to innovate and create new product which are attractive and appealing to individual and as well as corporate clients. It is true that the variations in Islamic product helps to foster market integrations and as well as attract investors. Even so, Islamic bank now is being accused to have a similar operation as its conventional counterpart. As we know, the real value propositions of Islamic banking is in terms of Sharia compliancy. So to be distinctive from conventional bank, Islamic bank should start thinking of enhancing its value propositions in terms of its contributions to social responsibility, which align with the applications of Maqasid al-Sharia, where the profit maximization is not the only objective of financial, and the social value should be part of its value proposition. For example, Islamic bank and finance must have social objective, which brings social reforms and promotes good economic agents. One of the good economic agents can be defined in terms of ethics. So Islam has its own distinctive value-based ethics system for dealing with business. which derive from the Al-Quran and as well as Hadith. Therefore, it is important for Islamic bank to set a certain threshold level of ethic. The second challenge is to have more Sharia scholars. For example, nowadays we can see there's a lot of complex banking product and structures due to the rapid growth of Islamic finance. New Straits Times 2016 reported that the lack of Sharia expertise is one of the key challenges limiting investment skill in Islamic financial. As an example, Tawarruk and commodity murabaha is only allowed by certain scholars. Therefore, the process governing this structure should be further improved to become more acceptable by more scholars. In order to innovate and securing long competitiveness in Islamic finance industry, the Islamic financial institutions need to develop more strategic leaders who have skill and qualified to serve Sharia Advisory Board and Sharia Advisory Council. For instance, by referring the Tawarruk issues that I mentioned just now, Sharia practitioners or scholars have to be more vigilant in ensuring compliance to the transactions of Tawarruk. This is to avoid damaging the reputations of the contract by taking shortcut.
There are several challenges in practicing and implementing Islamic wealth management, and one of it is legal framework. So Islamic wealth management is considered as an alternative way for individuals in preserving their wealth, and Malaysian can accept the Islamic way of management of management in wealth because of the majority of the Malaysian citizens are Muslims. And the problem is not because Islamic wealth management can be practiced by non-Muslim, but they are actually not confident with the details and the procedure of the Islamic finance. And legal framework is necessary as it opened the eyes of everyone that Islamic wealth management is a trusted and efficient way as other conventional financial product. And actually another challenges that faced by the Islamic wealth management, the challenges are in implementing the Islamic wealth management is actually public perception, in which it's from a non-Muslim perspective that all the practices of Islamic wealth management are quite foreign to them, and all the terms such as hibah, wasiyah, faraid, takaful, and even suku and other Islamic terms does not convince them to actually use the Islamic wealth management procedure, and they are actually not sure if a non-Muslim they can implement the Islamic finance, since they are actually limited exposure about the Islamic wealth management to the non-Muslim and to other community in Malaysia. Last but not least, actually minimize the constraints, in which there are several additional steps taken by the Malaysian government in minimizing challenges in the Islamic finance by actually establishing the Malaysia International Finance Center to develop and groom experts in Islamic finance, because they are actually limited expert in Islamic finance. So the implementation of Islamic wealth management is quite constrained to Malaysian public and also private banking sector, and also most of the Islamic and also conventional banks, they have limited product in Islamic wealth management. So banks such as Maybank, CIMB and many more, they are actually branching out to other Islamic finance products such as takaful products and banking system that are based on Sharia law, and finance and welfare are also introduced, and Islamic convention is implemented as a part of strategy to minimize the constraint when it comes to educating citizens of Malaysia about Islamic wealth management. And all public and private sectors are actually taking part in educating people more about the Islamic finance management.